Welcome to Mana Podcast, and today we have Vishal from Synconext. And Vishal, you defined your company as, you know, something that solves the efficiency issue when it comes to real estate, right? So Vishal, we just tell me how you started Synconext and what is it that made you start Synconext, because I think you were in the US before this, right? So how did the transition happen?
Thanks, Nikitha, for having me on your show. It's a pleasure to be on your podcast. So Synconext was started with a vision to be in the intelligence space. Okay. I had a stay in the US for a good about 8 years. I did my undergrad and my master's education there, worked for a couple of years, spent in a couple of companies. And I always had the intention to come back to India. Mm-hmm. And right from before, I had a dream of starting my own company. Mm-hmm. And I wanted to build something and build a, you know, an organization. And then I had a vision to be in the intelligence space. And that's how we started off the organization, which is quite earlier on. And we focused in the real estate industry and primarily in the commercial real estate space.
Okay.
So the last couple of years, we sort of, you know, it was our, you can say it was our true calling, and we pivoted in the sense we took a giant leap of our existing business.
Okay.
That would be in the IoT space, and IoT for commercial real estate. Okay. And that's how Synconext.
And what are the products? I think there are multiple products that you guys deal with, right?
So right now we're looking at three primary areas in the commercial real estate space.
Okay.
Broadly, they fall under energy,
mm-hmm.
space, and people.
Okay.
And what we mean by energy is typically your energy consumption for your systems, your lighting, your HVAC, and everything that goes within a building space.
So you're saying there are sensors that you know, collect data on how much energy is used and where is that energy being used and all of that, right?
So we use sensors. So we mm-hmm. use sensors in a very different way.
Okay.
We use sensors to collect data of occupancy.
Mm-hmm.
We use sensors to collect data about temperature. So we use a host of sensors to collect environmental data.
Mm-hmm.
Also, we use sensors to capture how people are behaving in the space, you know, when people are coming in, where they're getting occupied, you know, at what times of the day, which spaces get occupied. So we collect all.
What is the use of that data though? Like where is the application?
Yeah, so typically what would happen in large spaces, mm-hmm. you know,
mm-hmm.
People are in and out of their workplace. You know, today's age, there are studies that says that people spend less than 30% time at their desks.
At their desk. True.
Right. So it's a mobile workforce.
Mm-hmm.
People, even if they're in the offices, they are mostly in meetings, collaborations,
right.
All stuff, but not at their desk. Number one.
Right.
Number two, a lot of companies are now, you know, promoting, you know, work from home culture.
Correct.
For various reasons. I don't want to get it.
And,
yeah, whatever reasons, yeah. Right? And not just here in India, but across the world. And that's the mm-hmm. nature of work today.
Okay.
So what's happening is that there's a huge gap between people occupancy to all the other services that are being provided within a workspace.
Okay.
So we see a huge gap in understanding how spaces are being used,
mm-hmm.
How energy is being used, where energy is being used at different mm-hmm. times of the day.
Mm-hmm.
That's a huge gap in the system right now. And that's where we are looking to address the problem. So we use sensors to collect data,
okay.
Collect environmental data, occupancy data, data about how spaces are being used. The second area, other than energy and the larger impact is
mm-hmm.
The real estate cost itself. So rental costs that, you know,
rental
companies.
True.
Today, typically, you know, large amount of square footage is being consumed
mm-hmm.
without having a direct correlation of how they're being used, where they're being used, you know. In scenarios today, companies would say, hey, we need to reduce our costs. So typically what would happen is, all right, let's see where we can find a space at a lesser rental cost.
Correct.
So what we do is we collect data of how your spaces are being used. So we, once our data is available, we would present this to our clients and say, hey, look, I found that 30% of your space is used, used less than 20% of the time.
Correct.
Hmm. And that's a lot of real estate costs and money. People don't have real-time access to this. Mm-hmm. There are methods that people do. So mm-hmm. the second area that they're looking to address is the space.
Although, Vishal, before you move on to the second bit, right? So I've seen, like, when I used to work with an MNC, right? So, and I see that even if it's not the cubicles that we're talking about, but otherwise there is so much space and there is, that people don't actually use, but that's being paid for on a daily basis, right? So assuming you do collect this data and give it to them, are companies actually using the data and making changes in the company?
Yeah, so we've just started off. Because we've just started off, we are just starting to collect data in the last 6 months to 7 months. Mm-hmm. And the kind of data, even at the initial level that some of our clients are seeing, is actually an eye-opener. Okay. So nobody knew what was happening, and now this kind of information is available in their hand, and it sort of just it takes them off for a moment, and then.
So what sensors are these cameras that analyze how much traffic is being per area?
You can't use cameras. So use different type of sensors to collect occupancy data. So we know there is occupancy. We don't know who it is. We don't know how many people are there, but we know.
Continue.
The second area we're looking to address, Nikitha, is that around the space, real estate space usage.
Okay.
This large amount of space that has been rented out by companies. So we are attempting to use real-time data for management to be made available to see, understand how their spaces are being used at different mm-hmm. times of the day, different departments and different people.
Okay.
Until now, this kind of data was never available in real time. Typically, there would be manual audits or there would be data collected over a period of time, either through access control card, but mm-hmm. that's not granular, accurate data. So,
correct.
What we are attempting to do here is collect granular data about space usage, how people are using these spaces,
mm-hmm.
and then use this data in the most appropriate way. The third area, and that's where it gets really interesting, and mm-hmm. We are making attempts to grow our business, is the area of people productivity. The largest cost that companies have today is payroll, and people are. Everybody wants to make people efficient.
Correct.
So we are using today IoT technology to see how we can link productivity to spaces. And I'll give you a very classic problem today that most of the companies face. Mm-hmm. If you go to large companies, there are a number of meeting rooms available. And today, because of open office spaces, a lot of people are using meeting rooms more often than you would have imagined.
Right.
So what has happened is people want to use meeting rooms for ad hoc meetings, planned meetings, for whatever reasons.
Right.
And there is a complaint that meeting rooms are not available.
Right. You'll have to pre-book and then sometimes.
Yeah, so typically people would book, but they don't use it, and all kinds of friction. There are a lot of friction points.
Mm-hmm.
So we found a very sweet spot. We said that, look, you would use your calendar system to understand whether there's a space booked or not.
Correct.
But Google says whether it's available or not, whether it's being used or not. So because our sensors are there, we can know in real time.
Oh, it's actually being used or not.
What's being used, not being used. And we did a survey across quite a few different number of companies, and we found that people spend close to about 7 to 9 minutes looking for a meeting room when it's an unplanned meeting.
Very true.
So what
I used to do was go and peep into every single meeting room to see if there's a vacancy. So there's actually
Absolutely.
Minimum.
What would happen is you would peek in, use it, and then somebody would say, hey, we booked it, and then you would get booted off.
Yeah.
And then you start looking. And imagine what happens to productivity then. You're probably talking to four other people, you're on a call,
Correct.
All kinds of things. So we are looking to see how we can simply use technology within the, you know, the building domain
to
remove
productivity,
ease, and bring about efficiencies.
Okay. And does all of this come as a package, like all of these features, or is it three different products?
So it's a modular product as such. You know, mm-hmm. there are clients who are very keen on energy consumption, energy efficiencies,
mm-hmm.
But there are clients who are looking at understanding various aspects of their space as mm-hmm. well as using various productivity tools.
Mm-hmm.
So we could club this under, so for us, it's not a product, it's more of a solution.
Okay.
So we understand customers' requirements, and then
customized accordingly depending upon the number of people, depending upon the areas that are being used and all that. So how many clients do you have on board now, Vishal?
So we have close to about 20 to 25 plus clients.
Okay.
And different stages of interactions. Some clients have already deployed this, some clients are evaluating this,
mm-hmm.
But in the last 6 months we have made quite a few head start in terms of deploying this IoT product.
Okay.
So because we've been in the business for quite a few years,
mm-hmm.
We have built relationship with these clients. A lot of our clients are repeat clients, so we go back to them and say, hey, look, we've got this something new, what do you think, would you like to try it out? And more often than not,
they would,
because
want.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, they would want to use it. And then I'm happy to say that all our pilots have been paid pilots so far.
Okay, nice. And like, how long do the customers stay once you get them on? Because this is not something they would want to change, right? I think this is a product that they want to have for a long time, because if getting this for a year and then letting it go doesn't make sense. So I think the lifetime of the product is...
Yeah, it's longer. Definitely, lifetime is longer because the way we've pitched our product to the initial set of clients is
mm-hmm.
Their payoff from the product comes off from their energy savings.
Okay.
So whatever energy savings we are able to provide using our software,
mm-hmm.
so their costs are been paid off, and all the other applications around space, productivity, it's all a value add on top.
And the whole analysis bit, does Synconext actually work on analyzing each of these data, or the data is, you know, it's automated in a way that the results are shown on real time?
Mm-hmm. Both, right? So right now we are, so there is data that's available in real time.
Mm-hmm.
And there is also, you know, customers can generate reports for historical data.
Mm-hmm.
Right now, at the stage of the company that we are at, we are in the stage where we are collecting a lot of data.
Okay.
So now we are putting in team to understand, now that I have this data, how can we create analytics, how can we create actionable insights to customers so that mm-hmm. they can take actions in real time.
Okay. Vishal, you had a small trailer of the company, right? Just to give us a better idea. So I think it'll be nice if you can show that to us.
Sure, I'd love to share. This is just a teaser video that talks a little bit about what our product is.
All right. Vishal, before we move on to the next section, right, just one last question. Where does the production of the hardware happens? Does it happen in India?
Yeah, so we are a full-stack IoT company. So we work exclusively on the design of the hardware,
mm-hmm.
the software bit. But we, use our OEMs to do the actual production part of it.
Okay.
We believe that our strength lies in the design of the product,
right,
in the innovation side of the things.
Mm-hmm.
But we ensure that we work with the right vendors, the right partners, to ensure quality, to ensure the mm-hmm. robustness of the product that we promise to our clients.
And they're all Indian companies. All your vendors are Indian companies.
Yes.
All right. What's your favorite business book?
Good to Great.
Okay. What is the one thing that people like about you that you're aware of?
One thing that people
like about you that you're aware of. If you had to be very not modest for a second, go for it.
I think persistence.
Persistence. Okay.
Yeah.
If a biopic was made about you, which actor would play you? Like, which actor would you want to play your role? Bollywood.
Biopic, oh my. I think we are still too young for biopics. Or
it's okay to dream.
Biopic should be made about Amitabh Bachchan.
assuming Synconext becomes the next biggest thing, and there's a movie that's being done on you, which actor do you think would be?
I can't think of anybody.
Who's your favorite actor? Who's your favorite Bollywood actor?
Definitely, I like Amir Khan, Amitabh Bachchan for sure.
Okay, but so Amitabh Bachchan young... can't play you, I think, because he's quite old. So I think.
No, I like them. The question was who like. But I like the new young generation
mm-hmm.
Actors and the movies that they're making in Bollywood. Yeah. I think it's
the quality has improved a lot. Yeah. All right, moving on. What is the best advice that you've gotten with respect to business or personal life?
So many advices. I think what comes on top of my mind is you need to focus on your customer problem.
Mm-hmm.
And focus on customer and everything else would follow.
Fall in place. All right. Which new technology do you think will transform the future? Do you believe? Which new technology do you believe that will make a...
Yes, IoT is new working on for sure. Mm-hmm. I think so many studies. I think AI is, even though some people think it is hyped a lot, I think it is getting there. I think the time is coming.
Okay. All right. What would you say your biggest addiction is?
My biggest addiction?
Mm-hmm.
I'm not addicted to anything.
Not even Synconext.
Right now I'm addicted to work pretty
okay.
much, but
okay.
in that, I don't think I have any other addictions.
Okay, all right. What is better, being organized or attention to detail?
Tough one. I think being organized
mm-hmm.
for now, I think the stage of the company that we are at and the stage that we are, I think being organized because you need to address so many things.
Right.
Attention to detail is important. We are not looking for perfection as such.
Mm-hmm.
I think you just need to make fast and break fast and just keep learning and move on quickly.
All right. And if you woke up as, say, Amitabh Bachchan tomorrow, what is the first thing that you would do?
As Amitabh Bachchan, I would check how much money is there in my bank account.
Just for your knowledge, after you transform back. All right. Okay, so this is one last section of the round, right? So I give you a word, okay? And you tell me the first word that comes to your head. Okay. Success.
Hard work.
Future.
It's always in the future.
IoT.
IoT intelligence.
Family.
Support.
Synconext.
Synconext, we are the future.
Okay, all right, I think we're done with this round. So Vishal, moving on, so we usually address these two questions. Okay, so this is to get different perspectives from different people, and you know, different people who have started their own companies, right? So what do you think about the current startup culture in India? Right? Do you think it's being enough encouragement is being given to the startups in India? Or do you think it's doing well? Or do you think it could be better? Or what is your take on it?
I think we're in a very good space right now. As we look at the startup and you know being a part of this ecosystem right now, mm-hmm. I think we are in a brilliant point in time, mm-hmm. because I meet so many people, you know, with different perspectives, different age groups, different experiences. And I think I'm very upbeat, and what I see around also, and it just charges me up, because you know, we were primarily more of a service driven economy, at least in the IT side, but the kind of startups that are people are working on, both in the B2B space, B2B, BCC space, domestic business, Indian business, and actually going outside, mm-hmm. I think we are in a brilliant point in time. Mm-hmm. I think the next 10 years is for India.
Perfect. All right. And one last question. So what is that one piece of advice that you would want to give people who are starting new? Because you've been around, I'm sure. No, any. It doesn't have to be one.
Well, just starting new, is it?
Because you've been in the field for a while. You've seen the industries before also, and you know how. Yeah.
Yeah, so I also feel that many times when we come from a technology-driven product, we get too focused on what we can do with the technology. Mm-hmm. I've done that myself. And sometimes we have to recorrect our way of thinking. Correct. So what happens is we are too technology-focused. We mm-hmm. we focus on too much on what we can do. Mm-hmm. Sometimes in sight of, is it really solving a problem? Is it making sense to a customer? Mm-hmm. Is it making sense at a certain price? Mm-hmm. And I think getting that balance out is very important as we grow a business, as we get our feet off the ground in terms of getting customers, keeping customers on board.
Mm-hmm. All right. Is there another piece of advice that you would want to give?
No, I think the list would go on. But I think we have to, and I read this, and I think I can share this. Mm-hmm. So, listening to another podcast from Reid Hoffman and Tim Ferriss.
Okay.
And he said he had a different definition for grit. And mm-hmm. he said a lot of people think grit is just persistence. But he said, no, it's not just persistence. It is persistence, ingenuity, and laziness.
Okay.
And I think I struck a chord with what he had to say, because we put so much effort, and we said, we're putting in the hard work. But he said laziness means you need to find ways of finding efficiencies within your way of doing things.
Right.
Finding the right people, right? Find the right way of doing things. And he said it right. You know, grit is not just hard work, but it's also grit is smart work.
Smart
and
work.
I think some of it that you guys are doing it.
Right. All right, Vishal. I think we are done. Thank you so much for taking time out to do this. It was wonderful having you on the podcast. And
thanks, thanks for having me, and nice talking to you and to all your viewers out there.
Thank you.